In Australia, we have this concept of shared responsibility. Everyone has a part to play in mitigating and preparing for a disaster. Everyone has a part to play. And there are questions around, you know, who has what responsibility? Who should be doing what within our society? And those, there are no clear official rules, and there are very different belief systems about who is responsible for what. But ultimately, what happens during a disaster, during a flood, during a bushfire, is largely determined by what happens when the disaster isn't happening. So what happens before and after. So, for example, I've got a photograph here of an aftermath of a large rain event, and you can see that, you know, it's a relatively small problem. It's a flooded garage. Why did the garage flood? Well, the drain was totally is inadequate, so there's an issue in the building design. Also, the drain across the garage wasn't well maintained by previous owners. It was totally clogged up with rubbish. So whoever was responsible for maintenance didn't do it, which added to the impact of the problem. Now, this was a rental property, and the new tenants moved in 2 days before this event. They just managed to put all of their stuff into the garage, which then promptly flooded, completely destroying, you know, almost completely destroying their property. So there's a lot of issues around the landlord and tenant obligations in that scenario. You know, was the landlord maintaining the property? Was the landlord ensuring that the previous renters actually fulfilled their obligations? And how much information did the new tenant have about the state of the property, you know, before the rain event? So shared responsibility is actually a very difficult area to navigate, because everyone's got some responsibilities.